The moods had turned sour in Madrid, with riot police charging out of their fortified positions around the Spanish parliament and plowing into a vast crowd of protesters. Flocking to the capital from all across Spain, tens of thousands of demonstrators have joined a rally to express their anger with the government. Now let's now go to RT's Jacob Greaves, who's at the scene with more on this. Jacob, good to see you there. Now, some brutal scenes we're seeing in Madrid. Bring us up to speed on what's happening there right now.
Well, sure. In the last hour and a half or so, the situation here has really worsened somewhat. Now, we saw the front line of demonstrators clashing with police. There were some injuries involved there. After an ambulance had to fight its way through this amassed crowd, we saw someone being taken away on a stretcher. We've also seen protesters pelting police with objects as well. And really, we've got an impression of some of the panic felt by those demonstrators as police pushed them back. There are thousands of people here hemmed into a very small space. And when they're being pushed back, they've got nowhere to go. Now, this is all in aid of the so-called Occupy Congress movement. And we spoke to organisers throughout the course of today, and they say the aim wasn't to actually occupy physically the parliament itself, but what they do want to do is they want to send their message, make sure it's heard by those MPs inside parliament, as anti-austerity and anti some of the cuts. Now, we're joined at the moment by Carlos Steckles. He's a sociologist. Now, the situation behind us at the moment, again, is looking pretty precarious. Is this worth it to try and get this message across?
Well, I think actually that's the question of whether or not this is worth it is a question for the government and for the troika of the European Union. What you're seeing out here right now is the Spanish and, by extension, the European citizenry reacting against austerity. Now, austerity right now is at a level where it's affecting people's daily lives. It's affecting whether or not people can get medical attention. It's affecting whether or not people can advance socially through education and social progress. What you're seeing is a country where an entire generation is being relegated to a class of immigrants, people that have been invested in with public money to be educated, are now going to move out and generate wealth in other countries. That's not a project for a country. Meanwhile, child poverty in Spain has increased exponentially.
Stop you there. What can the government do right now to stop this sort of anger?
I think the first thing that the government can do is call for a referendum on paying back the debt and on the constitutional amendment that they made. It's no mistake that these people are gathered here today to talk about the Constitution of Spain. The Constitution that has been around since the transition from the Francoist government, and it was always said that it couldn't be touched, that it was the basis for what Spain is today. But they did change it without a referendum or even consulting citizenry or submitting it to public debate to pay back an illegitimate debt taken on by the private sector.
Thank you very much. I was going to have to stop you there now. As this protest continues, some of the anger being built up by the jobless rate. You're looking at unemployment in the country, the highest in the Eurozone. About 25% of the population, that's particularly hitting the young, those aged below 25. We're seeing them really out in force here at the moment today. And we are hearing at the moment that potentially there will be an announcement of the budget for next year being announced later this week, and there may actually be a stop when it comes to any more cuts to healthcare, to education, those that have really riled a lot of public anger in the last couple of months.
Right, thank you for that. Jacob Greaves, who's in Madrid right now, RT correspondent, giving us the latest on what's happening on the ground in Madrid.
Thank you. The crowd is now moving forward toward the barrier. The police have been telling everybody they're going to shoot if we don't move back. People are moving forward with their hands in the air, holding flags with both hands in the air. It's a mixture of people on foot, as you can see, people on foot and cowboys.
Remember, time to talk upstairs with Metro. All right, push these people back up off the gate. Push them back up off the gate. We're going to work to release these cattle. Listen to me. I'm going to work with you. I'm going to work with you, but I need you to back them up.
I understand that what you're doing, and you will get that time.
That's all right. But we're not playing. I know, I get that. But can we push them back up off the gate for right now? It's only going to be Bundy and his son.
It's the people or not, and you guys need to leave. You need to leave. That's
I'm telling you, you need to de-escalate the situation. I'm imploring upon you.
You are on Nevada State property.
There's a time for us now. We're doing that.
No, the time
is now. But you push these people back so they can do the same thing.
We respect your authority as county.
It's sad that, let those, we the people, do this. They this is their, they're going to get the job done. This is their job to do. And in that day, we found out that they were bringing those cattle home. So, you know, maybe it's not any of us. We can't take credit. Any of us can take credit for what's going on today. We're going to have to look up a little higher, up there where those birds are flying this morning, and thank our Heavenly Father.
So I just wanted to help you guys, but I'm going to get pretty choked up here. And I don't cry. Ask anyone in my family, but when we were on that mountain today, and we got to the top of the mountain and we prayed, and my brother-in-law gave the prayer, and he asked that we be protected and that our forefathers would be there to defend our constitutional rights. And I will tell you, I will testify 100% that we were. We took that horse, and we were in such a rush to go gather those cows, we didn't even realize we had a riderless horse, and we took them with us. We took our forefathers with us, and we took that horse up that mountain, and I will tell you that when we sat there at that gate and people were warning us to turn around because we were going to be killed, we had overwhelming feeling of peace up there, and those men that fought and died for this country so that we could enjoy our freedoms right now were there with us. They want us to be free, and they appreciated that we all stood and fought and took our lands back. And I don't want any of you, I packed this thing off that mountain, and I want you to look at it and remember the sacrifices that we made. This sign, never let this happen again. Never let our lands be littered with this garbage again. And don't you forget the emotions here this week. And remember our Constitution and all those men that died for us so that we could be here right now. Right.